Hi, my name is Mary. I'm a senior at Harvard College and I'm concentrating in computer science. And today we're going to do a walkthrough of the computer science curriculum with some added tips and tricks. I'm basing this off of the fall 2020 handbook. So if this is outdated, check the handbook. You should always actually check the handbook. You should also check in with the DUS and advisors because they are the final say on academic matters. I'm just a student making a video to try and help. If you're interested in computer science at Harvard, you are in good hands. There are more than 500 concentrators of computer science in 2019, so it is a big community with lots of places for you to find your own interest. Now, there's four types of concentrations. So you have your basic, you have your honors, you have a joint, and then you have the MBB track. I've attempted all three of them except for the MBB, so I'm going to leave that out because I don't think I can speak to it very well. The basic CS requirements for computer science are actually really short, so there's only 10 to 12 classes depending on how much of a math background you came in with. So for example, the first section is basic math and that's 2 to 4 classes. You can take 1A or 1B if you want to do a ramp up into math, otherwise you can go straight into multivariate calculus and linear algebra. A very common way of doing this is 21A, 21B, but there's actually kind of a variety of ways you can satisfy this requirement. So for example, I took AM22 for linear algebra, and then I took Stat 110 for calculus / probability. Then you have your basic software classes. So you have CS50, you have CS51, and you have CS61. They're all pretty programming heavy. They're all taught very differently. So it kind of depends on what you're interested in. You can also take all three, and if you do, it will count towards your technical elective. CS50 is also the only class you can take SAT UNSAT for your concentration credit. Then you've got your theory classes, which are 121 and 124. You've probably heard a lot about them. It is something that all computer science concentrators do together. Finally, you have four technical requirements to get your basic concentration requirements covered. There's quite a list here. One that I would really vouch for example, is CS20. Which is an intro to discrete math and will be a really good prep for the notation that you need for 121 and 124. Now, for your technical electives, they're going to actually have to cover a certain amount of breadth. So for example, 2 out of those 4 classes, the penultimate number, so the second last number, has to be from a certain series and they have to be from different series. So for example, the 40 series are hardware and networks. The 7 series are graphics, and this is a really good chance to kind of explore your interests. You don't need to write a thesis both for your basic or for your honors CS degree. The honors degree is only 2 more classes, so that's 12 classes to get it if you don't take 1A and 1B. Really, the only difference is that it has 6 technical electives instead of 4, so that's 2 more there, and they have to cover 3 breadth as opposed to just 2 as you would in your basics case. The joint concentration actually has even fewer requirements than the, you know, OG CS degree. It only has 9 classes, so the difference is you take down one of those technical electives, so instead of doing 4, you only have to do 3, but the catch is that, like all joint concentrations at Harvard, you must do a thesis at the intersection. So it can't just be one, it can't just be the other, they have to be actually at the intersection of those 2 topics. Finally, you have the mind, brain, and behavior track. Quite frankly, I never looked into it, so I can't speak to it, but definitely talk to your advisor if you're interested in this intersection between neuroscience and computer science. So one of the awesome things about computer science is that, and actually probably most liberal arts degrees, is that you can do so many things with it. Just because you studied computer science, that doesn't mean you can't study something else. So for example, you can switch into music, you can go to grad school, you can do law school, you can do med school. In fact, many of those schools see computer science as an asset. But I think typically what someone with a computer science degree might do is they might go into research or they might go into industry. So a lot of people do a lot of undergraduate research work at Harvard, and then they might go to grad school for that. And then in terms of industry, you have, once again, lots of options. Many people become software engineers, many people become data scientists or product managers. You might even work at the intersection between finance and tech. For example, I'm working venture capital, or maybe you're interested in the intersection of neuroscience and tech. There are really so many options that can come from a computer science degree. In terms of my best hack for the computer science degree, what I would say is, like I said, the basic requirements are really short. In fact, the computer science degree as a whole is really short. So if you need and if you want to take in-between classes to soften the blow of the next class, that's a great thing to do. So for example, CS20 was really great prep for CS121 and CS124. I took an intro algorithms class at MIT called 006, does not count for concentration credit or anything at Harvard, but it was a really great prep for 124. My point is, if you want to pad out the curriculum so that every class doesn't feel like so much of a jump, I really encourage you to do that. Also, there is a reason they order it the way that they do. You totally can take it in a different order, but I will say you have advantages in understanding the notation and having the basic foundational knowledge if you decide to take it in an order that's pretty much what they suggest. Thanks so much for watching this video. I hope you learned something. Computer science at Harvard is a really diverse concentration. There are lots of people, they have very many interests, and so you can definitely find your home in this department.